The secret reason why you feel wired but tired. Do you regularly feel wired but tired? Get to the end of a long and tiring day but find it difficult to fall asleep? Experiencing this once in a while is normal, but if you regularly feel this way, then there may be an underlying problem that needs to be addressed. One often neglected reason for this cause is iodine deficiency. Here's a quick guide to iodine, just in case you don't know enough about it. It's a trace element that's found in soil. Certain foods such as seaweed, dairy products, fish, shellfish, eggs, and chicken contain it. It's added to salt in the US because of consequences of deficiencies that are so dangerous. And it's an essential component of thyroid hormones, which is why it's so important for a healthy metabolism. How iodine impacts your sleep patterns. Feeling wired and tired is strongly associated with poor sleeping patterns, and iodine deficiencies are one of the most common problems of sleeping. And here's how low iodine levels may actually be keeping you awake. That's because low iodine levels means low level of thyroid hormones. And so when your thyroid hormones are low, your liver will also struggle to produce glycogen. Now, glycogen is stored in the liver and it's used as a source of energy when you're not eating regularly, such as when you're asleep. And this will cause then your blood sugars to drop if you're not producing as much glycogen. If your blood sugar levels are unstable at night, you will struggle to go to sleep and to stay asleep. And so low blood sugar will then also activate your body's stress response, which will then further dysregulate your sleep patterns. How iodine deficiencies can lower your metabolism and energy levels. Iodine is also an essential element for the functioning of your metabolism. Your metabolism is responsible for breaking down food and converting it to energy. And so when your metabolism is unhealthy, then you may suffer from low energy levels as well as weight gain. And so the pituitary gland actually is in your brain and it produces thyroid stimulating hormone, which then releases goes to your thyroid and causes a release of your actual thyroid hormone. And so iodine helps change TSH, which is the thyroid stimulating hormone, into TD, which is the thyroid hormone triiodothyronine, and also thyroxine, which is T4, which is your actual thyroid hormone. Insufficient iodine intake can actually cause metabolic dysfunctions, as well as general fatigue and weight gain. So if you're especially struggling to lose weight, it may be worth it to look at your iodine levels. However, it's important that you don't try to just supplement on your own, as an excess in iodine in the body can also be just as dangerous as deficiencies. How adrenal fatigue makes you wired but tired. Adrenal fatigue, which is caused by ongoing stress, is also strongly linked to the feeling of being wired and tired. There are a range of issues that can occur with adrenal fatigue that can bring on, you know, the wired and tired feeling. And that's because ongoing high cortisol levels can keep you awake even at night when you're trying to sleep and it's not dropping. Metabolic dysfunction can occur as your circuits become dysregulated. A poor diet resulting in deficiencies in essential nutrients like iodine can occur. And lastly, adrenal exhaustion caused by ongoing stress, high stress levels, can lead to an overproduction of cortisol and adrenal dysfunction. Late stages of adrenal fatigue can be difficult to identify and manage, so make sure you see a health professional who's aware of the condition that can help you on your recovery journey. How to correct iodine deficiency. There's a simple but not always easy way to correct iodine deficiency. You need to improve your diet. This will allow you to avoid the expense, trouble, and possible health consequences of supplementing to your correct deficiency. Basically, you need to get iodine through a natural, healthy diet, such as eating more fish, as it contains good levels of iodine and healthy fats and protein as well. Eating more vegetables, such as seaweed and kelp. Source your vegetables from, you know, people who are aware of and working to combat soil depletion, which occurs over farming, and that means your vegetables may have fewer nutrients. Make the dietary changes slowly and watch for adverse effects, and talk to your doctor about the changes you're making and possible outcomes. Thanks for listening today, and we hope that you get something helpful from this content. And if you would like to hear more great tips, make sure you click the subscribe button. Also, please like and share this video so our content will show up with other people who might need it. And remember, we're here to empower you to take control of your health.